That'll help the boys keep the range. So, those of you guys who wanted some surface combat, here you go. That's the best I can do right now. So. Hey folks, Pat here. Welcome back. Episode number 3, War on the Sea. War in the Pacific mod. Day 6, 1942. Or day 6, 4th March, 1942. 0500. The crack of dawn. And we have problems. So they came over here and blew the crap out of Moresby and are probably still hanging around here somewhere. We don't have any points. We only have 16, so we need to get as many naval assets down here as we possibly can. And so that means that we're going to start recalling some of these subs. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to shift them all. I'm going to take these guys and bring them down here, bring this guy down here, bring these two guys down here as well, because we need to put a screen of subs down here. So COMSUBPAC has got her COMSUBPAC has been ordered to join the fight down here and at least give us hopefully a few more assets, even though these are all American torpedoes, they'll suck, to try and help out. So it's going to take a while to rotate down here, but that's okay, we're still going to do it. So a lot of you suggest this, I agree with you. I also understand that US subs are a little OP, and that's why Wolfpack doesn't play with them. Or any subs in this game, especially Japanese boats with long lance torpedoes are freaking lethal if you're playing as a Japanese. So we're not playing as the Japanese, we're playing as the helpless Americans who have to rely on air power. And that's what we have over here. So now, a couple of you suggested that I break this up. It's tempting, but I think once we get our weekly batch of points, we'll barf out a convoy. We'll sneak behind all the buttons over here. They won't see us behind the buttons. So, and then we'll send these guys out to meet it. All right. But in the meantime, if we can catch those battleships on the way back, or that battleship that was Issei on the way back, I think this is our best bet. Let's check our weather for today. Yeah, good. It's nice and crappy down here. That's exactly what I wanted to see. So we'll be able to sneak over here. I think we're going to just park right in here. We're going to do more searches out of here. So we got a couple Kitty Hawks. Let's go ahead and kick another one out. Doing something a little jiggy jaggy like this. You can't go that far. Well, here, let's send the first one up first. So let's see where he's going. You're going that way. So you, brother, you go this way. There we go. RTB. Oh, damn it. Wrong button. So, okay, fine. Just make me wait for it, huh? Okay. Milne Bay ready to launch. Let's try this again. And not fat finger it this time. We still have our bow fighters. So, you know, all is not lost down here. We, of course, have no bow forts. So that part is lost. This button. There we go. But I think that we can actually do a pretty good job of covering most of our bases here. We gotta watch for this guy. He's down here somewhere. So, that battleship. Hate to run into him in the middle of the night. See, he's out here. So, that's why that guy's going up. Flying Fish has got a... Where's Flying Fish? Where are you? Did you just make a liar out of me? Oh, man. Just made a liar out of me. And said, hey, let's go check that out, Pat. Who is this and where are you going? So, hello. Hello? Any takers? Takers. Oh, they're coming right for us. Nav this way. Max speed. Do the order thing. Let's up scope. They're gonna be making 30 knots. We might still get a shot here. What do we got? Who are you? You are one of them little guys. So, not a full-fledged carrier, but we have light cruiser here, two destroyers. So that's okay. We take shots at any customers that want to do business with us, we take shots at them, if at all possible. Let's head right for them. Maybe we'll get the angle right. Let's ID this guy. Where are you? Here you are. I think we turn our radar on too. if I'm not mistaken. Hey, look at all this. So, we're not attacking you with airplanes, though. Ha ha ha. we're going to target you. 9,700 yards? What are you? CVL? Yes. Not that crane. Nope. You're a mystery. I don't know who you are. Are you actually classified as a CV? Let's take a look. Kagi, Kaga, Sweater, Hiru, Joey, Io, Tayo, Unryu, Rijo. No, not you. I have no idea what this carrier is. No idea. Let's see. Two large mounts, two little wings, two other mounts back here. One, two, tree. Might be you. So, close enough government work. Let's target that. So, 8,600 yards. Let's check out our attack angle here. We're gonna head right for him. There we go. Let's speed this up. Check our C-State. C-State 6. They're gonna have a hell of a time spotting us. You might bag yourselves a carrier here. But man, have I had bad luck with torpedoes lately. So, now there used to be a thing on here that would show you your, the attack angle. Oh, there it is. Never mind. Okay, so it's still there. See that little red dot? I mean, I got a mouse over it, so I can't point at it for you. So that's the thing that we want to get down pretty low. Because right now, our attack angle, the offset on the torpedoes would be 39 degrees. We want to get that down to about 15 degrees and then shoot. And oh my god, seriously, did you jerk spot me? Look at this. Everybody's going bananas now. That rarely happens in this game. You know what? I wonder if it's because I turned on the radar. Might very well be, but see how everybody here is angry now? Ruho, are you actually changing your heading? You're not. Let me turn off the radar. See if they decide to leave me alone. They won't. If she actually stays on course, we might as well just shoot. So, because her heading and her speed is not changing, which is insane. Both of those things should be changing. So let's go ahead and speed this up here a little bit, see if they still come after us. Yeah, but see that? Her speed and her heading is not changing. So there it goes. Now it's changing. Okay, fine. Alright. Boogie it. Cheese it out of here, man. So that's okay. Take the boat deep. Down scope. Haha. Oh no, that one. There's no submarine here anymore. What are you guys gonna do? So, yeah, so this game, especially the ASW, it doesn't work the same way as like a more detailed game on ASW like Silent Hunter 4 does. It's much, much more. Are they all coming after me? Or is she just changing course? No, she's moving again. So, yeah, whatever. There's nothing here. But anyway, as I was saying, there's very little in terms of... Let's see if they're actually depth charging or anything. I don't think so. Let's zoom in here and listen. You pinging? Pingy pingy? No pingy pingy. Watch you. These guys don't have, these guys do not have, sonar, if I'm not mistaken. Might be wrong about that. All the modern destroyers do. But it's just not as detailed. And so, like, you know, if you watch the first part of my Japanese campaign where I try and do the Silent Hunter 4 thing and just sneak away slowly, it never works. Okay? But if, and I think it was halfway through that campaign, or maybe early in the American campaign, someone said, just go deep and run, and I've never lost a subset, at least that I can remember. Actually, I think I lost one to air attack in the last series. So, Don't take my word for it. Try it. Don't try it. Whatever. But these guys are not going to fight me. So off we go. They were heading this way. So I wonder if they're just shooting out carrier groups to actually cover, like, play zone defense or something. I don't know. But we still need these guys down here because the main artery for us is right here to down here for now. And so that's very, very important. Let's keep going. Got to get the carrier out of here. I've got it set up right now, so these guys are just onesie-twosies, and so if we have a cooldown on any of these, it'll be like 5 minutes, and so we'll still be able to get cap up almost instantaneously. So these are all from different carriers, too. Or no, they're all from one carrier, too. So here's this guy. Heading this way, which is crazy. Of course, we don't have Darwin, so it's like right down there. Otherwise, we'd be able to do something about that, but it'll be interesting if we have to watch this side of this, but we'll do it. We'll do the things. So, okay, there's my command points, 53, and so now it's time to start figuring out convoy stuff. So convoy stuff, what is our priority? Let's do some prioritization here. I've been thinking about this a little bit, but I'm going to commit now. Let's see. Horn Island, 1,000, 1,500 troops, no engineering. They do have engineering. That's actually really good to know. So they might actually be able to, they might be able to get these guys back up, because I think engineering is $1 a due. Hang on. No, not that. That one. One fuel, one engineering, 10 supplies per replenish airfield plane. So I only need 3 engineering, 3 fuel, and supplies. So that has changed. So I think I checked that before and it was 0. How about you? We have engineering and supply. Oh, no, wait. That's not actually what you have currently. Damn it. That's what it requires. It's over here. So, yeah, never mind. We have no engineering. We have fuel, but no engineering. So, we're not going to replenish our planes. Man, I was looking the wrong damn thing. And some of you are probably like, huh, Pat, you're looking the wrong damn thing. You're right. So, I'm not going to really worry about Horn. At least not right now. Port Moresby, since they blew the crap out of not just the port, but the airfield. So just to get it back to a level 3 is going to take 500 supplies, 500 fuel. And so I don't think Port Moresby is actually going to be our forward port. Alright, we're going to build that later. Somewhere that makes a little bit more sense than way down over here. In fact, something like this might make a little bit more sense eventually. Or this. I'll take that. No, I'm just kidding. So. Or maybe this, you never know. Or this, alright. Suggestions on that one, but I don't think it's going to be very easy to actually get stuff down here. Contrary to that, it's already up 1, so that's one run that we wouldn't have to do in order to get it to a level 3. What about Santa Cruz? That one might make a little bit more sense too. Yeah. But as far as airfields go, I think this guy's our ticket. Nah, I get it. That means we won't have murder hornets here for a little while. Because this got destroyed. Which sucks. But we have Australian version of murder hornets right here. And so we might just use those instead. So my thinking is as such. Let's sit down and figure out what we want to buy. Because I want to set up a bunch of little convoys, maybe like 2 or 3 of these guys that we can get for whatever command points we're going to get a week. That way we get about 3 of them set up within 3 weeks. And they just do shuttle runs. Okay, so we're going to build infrastructure here for a little bit. What do we want them to have is going to be, we do need fuel down here. So we have 10 fuel, so we need to get a lot more fuel down here. So at least 2 runs with one of the big, the Cimarrons. One of these. Oh, God dang it. New. Thank you. One of these. So it's $14 out of 53. And then the MS, the, what is it? The C3 holds both the most supplies and engineering. And not as many troops, about 1,000. I don't think we can get three of these. So 14 plus 36, right? Because they're 12 apiece. 14 plus 36 puts me right at 50. So let's do two. And so our first run will be engineering, troops, gas. And so that's 38, which leaves me 15 points. We can give these guys two decent destroyers to help escort. And so let's do that. Give me some destroyers. Farraguts are fine. Take those. All right. So that's 52. We got a single French fry left in the box. So there we go. Now, if this guy gets caught by a carrier, they're all going to die. So, but it was a week's worth of points. So, okay. So it's not end of the world. All right. But if we can sneak him down there, even better. All right, here we go. Let's do our, what do we want? No. I think we just do two column. Yes, no. I don't think it really matters. Yeah, we could do this. We have a one where there's two out front and then everybody else. No, not that one. What is the convoy one? Yeah, we could do this one. 5 and 4 as our destroyers. Yep, that works. Spread it out, boys. And here we go. Let's manage our cargo. So we need gas. Troops. And see, this is an important thing, is that we actually need to start shooting these troops out, because I was reading in the rules, if you get over 10,000, you stop accumulating them, and so we don't want to waste any weeks here. So let's get some troops out, and let's kick out some engineering as well. All right, then, of course, hug the edge of the map, please. Thank you. What's my range? So this guy, 650. Yeah, see? Doesn't mean they won't spot us. It just doesn't mean they won't be able to send out planes if the information, the intel that I received from Magic is correct. So, all right, here we go. This guy's going to get away, unfortunately. SBD3 Dauntless, what do you got right there? 1CV, 1MS. Really? Really? Say it ain't so, Joe. It ain't so. This guy armed? This guy's armed. We're not gonna shoot at him. You are bowfighter bait. That's right. We might want to actually send out groups of planes from... look at this! Even better. So, go up there and do something about that, boys. So, we might want to send out little roving bands I'm not going to call these guys murder hornets. We all know what that is. But, bees. So, SBD, SBBs. I don't know. It's my boat fighters. Hey, look at that. Hello. We've got some business here today. So, down. Ooh, juicy, juicy. Hit the deck, please. So, deck, max speed. Let's form up. Let's keep it in Vic. Ooh, what do we got here today? Yummy, yummy. This guy is not armed. This guy is, so you are excellent rocket bait. This guy here is... this is the one with the single rack. So, I don't know if that's what that's called. So, when I worked on the railroad, this was called a fuel rack. So, I don't know if that's what it... I don't know. It's a pipe that the fuel goes through. So, we use it to fill trains. So, or tankers, I guess, in this case. So, let's see. Yep, looking nice and hungry here. Stay nice and low. Nippon Maru does have guns, so it's almost as much fun as murder hornets. Yeah, I give the bowfighters a little bit of love in this game. As long as we don't lose too many of them right off the bat. It'll be nice to get the bowforts back too. That'll be another it'll be another good reason to beef up Milne as quickly as possible. And like I said, once we get that train running, who knows, they might try and interdict it. It might be rando when they do that. They're popping shots at us here. One's a little short. We're going to wait till we're down to about 1,800 yards, pop up. Hit the attack button. Here we go. Up we go. Here we go. In we go. Let's take a look. Let's watch the fun. Ooh, rockets. 1942. British rockets. I think that one's a win. I believe that one's a win. So, gentlemen, form up. Line ahead. Form up on me. Up, down. Get out of range here. Wait for this guy to sink. Critical, critical. Let's kick it way out here. Speed this up. Wait for this dude to burn down to the keel. Yep, I don't have to wait that long. So, let's head on in. You guys, take your speed down just a notch. You can spread out here a bit. There we go. Slow down. Let's go grab this other guy while we're at it. I think it's like 5,300 tons, something like that. Not you, you. Yes, no, no, MS, you are not that dude, this one right here, this guy, oh no, the one with the boxes, this one, 3,100 tons, not as big as I thought, that's okay, we're still going to put some bullets into you. Is he targeted? He is targeted. Yep, hit him from the rear. Down again about 1,800 yards. That guy's donezo. So we're gonna add two more points to our lone French fry left in the box. And here we go. After the last episode, I am kind of looking forward to maybe something a little bit more quiet, but we have to be vigilant about anything that's coming down to invade now, because it looks like we're actually gonna win. Oh no, not that. I totally jacked that up. Boat. Yes, that. Yeah, yeah. Target that guy. Hit the right button, dummy. That button. There we go. Totally lost my train of thought. Whatever. These guys have 20 Mike, so they should tear them to pieces. Yeah. maybe it'll just take one, but you never know. Form up, drop down. Let's see. Looks pretty good. Heavy, heavy. One more pass. We got lots of ammo. When in the Bismarck Sea, expend ammunition. Let's go around this way. Gentlemen, why are we still going max speed, man? Chill out. Chill out on that stuff. Spool some of that speed out. Come on. In line, bro. You just had another secondary explosion right there. There we go. Follow me. Attack button. Pop up. Drop down. She's exposing her side to us because she's listening to the port here. Which is great. Oh, looks like she had some ammo on board, huh? Not my problem. Yep, donezo. So, alright. So, that's two quick kills for the day. We'll take it. Off we go. 4 command points for that. Sweet. So, RTB, folks, don't get chased by zeros. Yeah, and I'm gonna boogie with those guys too. So, oh, don't care about this. Yeah, I'm gonna boogie with all my Dauntlesses. So, not gonna spend. I mean, this game is gonna take how long to capture all the? Oh man. So, don't get to shoot down my planes, man. ugliest plane ever. Fight me. I know some of you guys like it. I'm just messing with you. So. All right, so all the action is on this part of the map down here. P-40 Warhawk, that's this guy way out here. Don't care about that. We can ignore that one. Don't care. So yeah, they're going to cheese it out that way and just basically, you know, pop the birds over it. Darwin over there, which is conveniently off the map, but that's okay. No, begin, start, ignore, off we go. Milne, same thing, don't care, off we go. All right, so carry group's getting close here. I'm sorry, scrolling on this one is going to be a little pesty for a while. Let's get the carrier over here. So, nice and safe. We'll set up all our search patterns again in the morning. In fact, let's just RTB all these guys tonight, and we'll redo it all in the morning. So, we want to have a nice batch of Dauntlesses heading on out and definitely covering this gap right here, and then maybe things up here. I mean, we can always send a Dauntless group up there too. Or some Avengers. I don't know if the Avengers have rockets. We might have to go investigate. So, in the morning. So, there we go. One more day down. But I feel better already. If the convoy does show up in here, we are going to wreck it. And so, or at least that's the plan. So, air ops now available. Oh my gosh, it's so far down here. So, I want these Dauntlesses to RTB. I thought I had them all policed up, but apparently not. No, RTB. And the other one. Not Midway. Lex, RTB. Alright, we'll figure this out here in a few minutes. We got some time. How's the weather? Weather's nice and crappy. That's what I want to see. Halibut, get down here. I wonder anything coming from truck will actually come down around here. So let's get a boat over here. Let's get another boat over here. Drum, I want you to come down. And we're just going to form a Congo line. Submarines down here, at least for a little bit. That'll do. The other thing that we got to consider is that eventually we'll have to rearm these guys. So we don't have a base down here to do it with. So... that's okay. All right, Lex, let's set up our screen. Sorry, this is going to be a little bit tedious, but we will have to do this from time to time. Let's do these none, so we don't get the cooldown penalty. We're going to go 680 nautical miles. We're going to get chased by zeros like crazy. So let's do something about like this. And I get it. This will change as we move. So we're going to be a little bit more heavy, going out to the east here. Launch aircraft, give me another one. Something like that. Give me another one. A carrier button. Where are you? There you are. Lex. I think we'll do about 5. Of these, so this is number 3, and we have the P-40 Warhawks helping too, so it'll be okay. Let's do something like that, and rinse and repeat. And actually, these patterns have been sticking, so I don't know who fixed that, but the last 2 saves we have not had to do this, and so that's really, really nice because that's Wildcat. I don't want Wildcats. Screw that. No Wildcats. Dauntlesses. Wildcats are for other things, because Very likely that we're gonna get spotted. So that's okay. Hey, if Revolve starts sending stuff our way, let's see here. 650? So we're gonna be in range of their Bettys down here. We'll shoot them down. So I don't have a problem with that. This should be pretty good coverage coming out of here if they actually decide to start doing that. And then on top of that, we have air cobras over here, so that we can use as well. Let's get the carrier over here. So I'm gonna put a whole bunch of land between you and me. Counter with Dauntless. Yeah, see, we're gonna be doing this quite a bit. So cheese it. Unfortunately, that's just gonna be something that we're gonna have to work around for a while. So, but we've got all kinds of busy bees around here. Something comes in here, we should be able to spot it while our convoy ever so painfully and slowly makes its way down here to help. we do have herring out here as well. Yeah. We're gonna turn her loose a little bit. Just let her patrol. Okay. These guys are coming down. Five command points. 0500. See, there was a whole day that just melted off the calendar. We're gonna have quite a few of those over time. Oh, thank God. My patterns are still working. So, see what you got, man. We're waiting on you now, brother. So, famous last words. Enemy troops defeated at Port Moresby, so, man. Well, maybe that'll make them mad and they'll decide to do it again. So, who knows. Encounter with Finback. What's Finback? Attic? Halibut. Look at this. Shoot, you know what? We might want to keep these guys out here. That's two contact. Well, I guess the other one was way up in Japan. But here we go. Let's do some submarine. What have we got? Look at his nice clear day. Where are you guys going? You guys are heading towards me? That's a bad idea. What do we got here? We got Merchies. We got two Merchies. Ooh, I wonder if these guys are unarmed. I bet you they are. I know this guy is. At least I'm not sure. This is the, what, the... Can't remember. George, you'd be ashamed of me. You told me it like three times. I think I called it a Hog Island. You're like, that's not a Hog Island. I can't remember. Oh, no, we want this. You are... This dude. And this guy is armed. See that right there? That's bad. You don't want that. Let's see. I learned in the last one, you do not attack armed merchant ship surface. It's a very bad idea. So, wait a minute, where are you? This guy right here. This might be the one with the decorative gun. Yeah, it says it's unarmed. I'm inclined not to trust it. So, we'll see. I know the other guy isn't. Let's go ahead and put some fish into this dude. 6,000 yards. We got absolutely ideal attack angle here. Let's just do 3 torps, 1 degree spread. That might sound like overkill, but with U.S. torpedoes, he planned on at least a 50% dud rate. And so if I get 1 into her, she'll probably blow up. If I get 2 into her, she'll definitely blow up. And if I get 3 into her, we'll basically obliterate her. But that gives me 3 chances to get at least 1 hit. So we're going to take. Well, let's see, we can go and speed this up. I don't even think I have my scope up, do I? Oh, I do. Look at that. There are airplanes here, they'd be like, oh, that's a submarine. There's no airplanes here. Aha. Uh-huh. At least not that we can see. Yeah, I'm curious how the last guy spotted me. I bet you it was a radar. I don't know, do you have radar detection in this game? You might not. You know what it probably does is it probably increases your chance of visibility. That would be my guess. So rather than something that's like strict, kind of like, oh, there's a submarine over there because bouncing radar signals off us. I don't know though. Some of you might. Well, I guarantee you a couple of you do. So, you've designed all the things, so, and popped the hood and know how to build the engine. So we're in an excellent attack position here, so we can just play it nice and cool. Go back here, check on this. So we want that attack angle to get down to about 15 degrees. So we could shoot right now, but if we get that down to, I think it's about 15 degrees, boom, your torpedoes go out straight. Although I've tried to do this like 5 times now, the last 5 sub-attacks that I've had, and I keep jacking it up, so it's entirely possible that I'm completely full of shit. Actually, that's a distinct possibility. Yeah. Because this 36 degrees here, that's your... What is that called? It's called your angle on the bow, right? Yeah. Angle on the bow, if I'm not mistaken. No, it's not. Maybe it is. I don't remember. I haven't played Silent Hunter 4 in a while. So, I've been trying to play it. It's not cooperating. Much to my chagrin. Let's get it down to 20. So, 20 is good enough. 22, 21. Shoot. We can watch the fish go out. That's always fun. Here they go. Whee! Yeah, see, slight offset angle. There, so yeah. Or maybe, you know what, I got it backwards. We want that down to zero. Yeah, we want that down to zero. Because that means there's no movement on the fish. The dot is where the target is. Now I remember. Like I said, it'd been a while. But then after that, yep. Normally we'd only do that at night, but I don't see any, I don't see anything that's going to give us much of a problem. So, there's a fish, nice calm, clear day. Let's see if their heading changes at all. Probably not. We can go ahead and speed this up. That'll only take about 10 seconds here. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh my god, are we going to miss? We are not going to miss. Ooh. Ooh. With 99% solution, we overshot. We blew our wad a little early. That's okay. I think that one hurt. That was pretty violent. Let's see. Critical, critical. Yeah, she's gonna sink. Oh, let the chase begin. So let's see, when we do this, we want to do a spot. Yeah, she's going down hard. Look at that. Deck's hard to wash. It might actually even put her fires out. But look at that, her rudder's about to come out of the water. All right, let's get on the surface and do some chasing here. So, surface boat. There she goes, she's done. Surface boat. Let's do some chasing here. What's her speed? 13 knots. We can do better. There's our boat. The chase is on. Here you go. Here's your screenshot, maybe. Let's see if she starts shooting. We start shooting. No, we're not going to shoot. So, why not? Oh, because I didn't tell him to. Commence firing. There we go. Oh, I hit on the first try. Gotta love it. There we go. Let's do some chasing. Let's see if I can get it while we're shooting. I doubt it. There's a hit. There we go. Let's see. That's 3 shells. Got her. Let's check our speed. 14, hers is 15, so I don't really mind if she opens up on us just a little bit, so in terms of distance, but actually I think we can match her speed. There we go. That'll help the boys keep the range. So, those of you guys who wanted some surface combat, here you go. It's the best I can do right now. let's speed this up. Whiff. See? You might be missing now. Bonk. Yeah, see? I don't know. Maybe that's a glitch. Maybe we're actually registering hits. There's no way to tell. So, we'll just go ahead and do it this way. Moderate, minor. Yeah, this won't take too terribly long. So, it just will be a little bit more lengthy than some of our other little whiff. Way to go, dude. I think that was our first bona fide miss. So, let's see. We're on this right here. AP? Why are you guys shooting AP? Captain's bad. So I need to cease fire on this. Load with HP, or HE. And now shoot again. Let's try this over. Much better. So, although in the past I have used AP shells, basically punch a bunch of holes into something. I think I did it out of desperation. I don't think it was actually, I think it was actually out of shells when I did that. That was somewhere in the last series. That might have been the sub that I lost, come to think of it. I remember I had a hell of a lot of trouble with one of them, trying to get it to sink in the middle of the night. Let's check our report. Moderate. Go ahead and speed this up here and just see if those are actually misses. 1, 2, 3. See how they're all hitting in the same spot? 4, 5. I think that might be a glitch, but let's check. If it's not a glitch, then this would be heavy, heavy now. I'm actually missing when I do that. So here we go. We'll just wait for something to go boom. So speaking of things going boom. That tanker is awfully close. So, throw out some food and water for those boys. Poor Japanese boys. Probably Korean boys. Who are not going to get picked up by their Navy. Because it wasn't in the nature of the Japanese Navy to go rescue survivors. So, there's not supposed to be any survivors if you fight hard enough, right? Or at least so the theory goes. So, down she goes. That's kind of neat, too. I don't know, I kind of like that one. So, we're going to be stuck here. We might as well have some fun with the photography. So, we'll see if I can get it when we actually shoot. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nope. Oh, come on. There we go. I don't know. I'm just playing around now. She's listening, though. So we're registering hits over here. How are we doing on ammo? Oh, we got tons of them. Let's see if we can get her in like 5-10 more shells. She's listing pretty hard. That guy's done. Way over here. I got the angle. So, closing in just a little bit might help. Especially in calm seas like this. But, Finback. I think this is going to be our first sub kill. So, We missed Shokaku. That light carrier ducked out on us. Or we kind of ducked out on them because they spotted us. So this is our official first submarine kill of the war, USS Finback. And see, the reason why in Silent Hunter 4 I was playing as a Swordfish, because the Swordfish was a ship that got the first official kill of World War II. Well, I mean, for the Americans, of course. I mean, the Germans had been doing it for a while at that point in time. So, but, you know, a little bit of sub-combat is a nice break. Especially when we have just, like, this, which is just murder victims here. As opposed towards, like, oh my god, are they gonna find us? Are we approaching crushed death? So, because if you watch my Japanese series, man, I lost a lot of subs in the beginning. I lost a lot of submarines. But in the American one, I think I only lost one after you guys started giving me some tips on those. And that was actually pretty cool. So, But again, it does make him a little bit overpowered. So, come on, sink. So, I know when you say that, it never happens fast enough. But we're getting pretty close here. It'll probably take about 10, 15 more. Let me speed this up and see if we're still splashing. Yep, still splashing. Let me speed up. So, I don't know what the deal with that is. This hit registry doesn't work the same. I don't even know if that's a thing in this game. So, I'm just making things up now. So, but, I do appreciate all the support and comments that you guys have been dishing out, over the course of this episode, or this series so far. It is going to be a long haul, and so we might break up some of the work in the future. Meaning that we're going to have a lot of different operations going on at once. There we go, there's a good explosion. And you guys have been doing a really good job of providing good strategic feedback, and I kind of make decisions based upon that, but... we might break things up here a little bit so that we have a little bit less work to do. Of course, I still gotta drive, but you guys can tell me where to go. So, you can be designated a backseat driver on some of these things. Come on, man, this guy's gotta be almost done. Let's check our report. We might want to save ammo. Flooding is not quite critical yet. So let's just pump about 3 or 4 more rounds into her here. What are her shells at? 82. Let's give her 2 more. 1. Boys getting some target practice in today. Of course, every gunner's mate in the entire silent service. This is their dream at this point in time in the war. And there we go. They can go ahead and paint one on the boathouse here. Or is that what it's called on a submarine? On the conning tower. There we go. So, all right, she's done. So let's get out of here. That should be 4 more dollar dues. We'll take him. So in the future, we might get a little bit, like, I don't know, not quite as bloodthirsty, but until we get to that 100 ships, we're going to take opportunities, especially ones like that that present themselves. I'd be curious. So Guam wasn't too far away there. I'd be kind of curious if they actually could barf out planes in time. Because I remember just in the base game, if you were doing like a sub attack up in here, so every now and then things would show up in Rabaul or from Rabaul like almost immediately after you're done, because they would immediately kick out a counterstrike, an ASW airstrike. And sometimes they would catch you. And that was a bigger problem in the base game, where you actually had to dive the boat. All right, so once TTE came out, I think it was TTE, it might actually be in the base game during one of the updates, if there were no ships, I mean, if there were ships in the area, you would actually start out submerged. And then if there weren't ships in the area, I think you started out on the surface, which is how I lost that submarine. Yeah, that's correct. So these guys are just buzzing around, not doing much here. This is inviting submarine disaster, I just realized. So we're gonna do a little loop-de-loop patrolling down here. So gotta be careful, man. So I don't know if they know where we went. So we have not seen search planes over here. If they knew that we were down here, they would probably be trying to airstrike us all over the place. But there's been no searches down here. There's been no sightings so far, and there's another day that melts off the calendar, and our convoy slowly making its way. So what we're going to do, let's see, how far out is this? 650 miles? So when that guy gets a little bit down here, so we will probably run out. Stop that. And go dog catch them in. So, what are we at now? 48 minutes? Yeah, we might be able to do that today. So, let's just see what happens here. You're not finding anything, so why don't you just start working your way back up this chain here. See if we get anything coming out here. Otherwise, maybe we'll actually send one of these boats back up in there, because that was actually pretty good. Yeah, let's send somebody between these two spots. Now that he's gotten all the way down here, it's like, God, man. So guys at Pearl need to make up their minds. It's like, chill out, bro. You got a kill? That was Flying Fish, right? No, that was Finback. For the record books. So we are just scrubbing this area down, though. And melting days off the clock. So Like I said, we'll probably have a few episodes that are like this, with other ones that are pierced by absolute terror or destruction. Those are the ones that I definitely want to see. So we got this spot here covered pretty good. I'm pretty happy with our coverage here. So why are you still burning, man? So they're still burning. We might not want to send all the engineering. We might send a little bit of that engineering up here. I don't know if I can split the load, though. Well, I could drop it off at Milne, and then drop it off in Moresby, and then pick it back up and drop it back off. That's dumb, but I get it. All right, so they got to make it out to about here. Let's see how far that is, how long that'll be. Oh my god, it'll still be almost 2 days. So, that's okay. It's probably time to start thinking about sneaking the carrier out. 0500? Where will we be at in 24 hours? So, we're going to do some coordinating here. Like I said, we got to be a little bit more careful about this. So, 24 hours gets us out close to Guadalcanal. Let's go ahead and shoot out here. And then we can run out here during darkness and pick these guys up. So, and then we can escort them in. And that'll only leave this halfway uncovered for about a day. So, famous last words. Watch them show up with, you know, 3 hospital ships full of 20,000 dudes. just blah. just barf out all those guys on my island. One more thing, we actually should probably set up. We're going to be sending convoys south up here. We should probably set up ASW. That goes due south. 680. Let's do. Way too much. 680, dude. Pay attention. What about like. So the carrier's out here in the open, and we've got no customers. We're going to need to send out another batch of folks on the radial going over this way in the morning, which is fine. Oh, actually, that was stupid. That puts me over here during daylight. Moron. Dirk. Oh, well, maybe they won't. Air ops now available. Cool. All right, let's do 2 more. Oh, well. Commander's mistakes. Do it all the time. Something about like that. Rotate. And 1 more. I'm only using about half a dozen Dauntlesses here to do this. And I get using the radio dial, this thing. I mean, it's there for convenience, but it is such short range that it is almost useless. So, except for the convenient part. We don't have anybody going up this way. The convenient part is not useless. So, it's just, these guys can go out so much further if you do it by hand. So, that's what we're going to do. So, let's go. Rinse and repeat. That guy's gonna go up to Rabaul, get jacked. Actually, this will work out. This will work out. How's our weather? See, the weather here is pristine. So, now it's pristine down here. There we go. We got 46 command dollar reduced left. And so we can go grab ourselves another convoy here in a minute. In fact, why are we waiting to do that? We should be doing that now. So, 46 is not quite as much as we had last time, but that's okay. We can get pretty close. Actually, you know what we can do? We can buy one of the little tankers. There we go. So, because little tanker to big tanker, ta-da, that's 200 fuel. So, so let's do that. No, not you. You guys. Yeah, so let's get a little tanker. Let's get 2 more C3s. No, not the Macaulay. C3, 1, 2. So it's 31. If we got 1 more, we'd only have 5 left. What else can we get? Arcturus is only $7. So that would give us 31 plus 7, 38, which would only leave us with $8. Yeah, that's not enough. Now let's go ahead and just get two more Fletchers. Or, I mean, not Fletchers. Farraguts. And bam. So, USS Hull, welcome to the fight. So, I've seen her many times. In the past. Wasn't she the ship that was leaving Pearl Harbor? So, if I'm not mistaken. Or is that the Phelps? I don't remember. Some of you nerds know that. I should know that too, because I'm also a nerd. So, alright, there we go. Alright, so in this one, let's do cargo. And let's do gas, of course. Let's do supplies, since we're not getting enough of those. And let's do troops. Alright. That's not as much engineering. I mean, it'd be really good to get enough engineering down there where we didn't have to do two of these, but I don't want to waste the supplies either. We need to keep this train moving. Now understand, in another week we'll have another convoy. So eventually we'll be able to stem that tide off and not be doing this and start saving money for, you know, cooler things that do cooler things. Shut up, you idiot, man. It's me. Anyway, all right, here we go. We're loaded up. Let's get back here and do the things the way that they're shaping up to be done. Oh, wait a minute. I don't need to go quite that far. I think we're good as long as we kind of hug the buttons over here. All right. So, in theory, these convoys will kind of pass each other on the way back. Maybe. We're just going to have to see. 1800, back to darkness. And so, how far? We're just going to keep this guy rolling. No, apparently not. So, see, it's, yeah, there's no way to get this guy thoroughly in there. It just moves too slow. But we can do something like this, just jiggy-jaggy around with their carriers, and at least keep, and in the morning we can launch Cap. And put Cap over these guys. Actually, that's all we really need to do. And then just keep the carriers kind of close. So, but we can launch up like 12 Wildcats and put them over those guys. I mean, we could put a full 24 over them, but let's just go ahead and do that now with Lex. And then we'll hit the rinse and repeat on this one. So here we go. Let's just do 12. I think 12 will be good. Done. So we want this down to nothing. And we want them over task force 22. So 22 is this one, 23 is the other one up there, and then we want this to repeat. I think, yeah, there's no way to tell whether or not to do it. I think the line's right. We'll just watch them. So here we go. Alright, so they're over the carrier. Or, I mean, they're over the thing. P-40 Kitty Hawk. Man, that's the first time we've seen a Zero come out here in a couple days. I think all the Japanese were on holiday or something in there, because they weren't really messing with us that much. Maybe they'll start coming back out. So now, unfortunately, this means for the time being, we only have these two guys in here kind of patrolling around. It's okay, though. It's a narrow window. Calculated risk. Okay, so that guy is rinse and repeating. See how he's going up there and then scrubbing back down? The only thing that sucks about that is that we do have to do that regularly. Here we go. One merchant ship and one oiler. What time is it? 1609? We got enough time to launch both fighters. Yeah, let's go check this out. I bet you it's just a little onesie-twosie group again. Here they are, way out there. Check them out. Yep. Same deal. This is the one that's definitely armed. So, or no? No, it's not. This is the one that might not be armed. This guy's not armed. Yeah, let's go ahead and send the bowfighters out. But, oh, wait. Oh, don't do that. Oh, crap. Totally didn't see which direction they were heading. Oops, pilot error. Bowfighters. Rockets. I don't know if you guys meant to put rockets on those. But we're gonna use them. I think they were heading south or southeast. We'll chase them down. We know where they're going. If they're heading that direction, we know where they're going. Going down here. If they're heading towards Rabaul, they're going to get away. So, that's dumb. Oh, did you see that? That makes me nervous. Just a little glimpse of a plane there. Come on. Come on, guys, cooperate. There we go. Get down there. Yeah, so look at that. We've been spotted down here. Something's been spotted. Something of ours has been spotted. We need to put the carrier in between it and whatever's, because these guys are not coming from this far away. There's definitely a carrier in here. It's getting pretty late in the day, so we're going to be able to give them the slip. Bow fighters actually have contact. Oh, dang, I totally forgot about this. These are zeros now. Those ships are long gone. So, that's okay. There's a lot of war left. Go back home, RTB. There's a carrier in here, though. Coming after our convoy. I mean, it's possible that they came from Tarawa or somewhere else, but I doubt it. So they're going to try and be in position in the morning. It's possible that they did not spot the carrier. So, which would be hilarious. Run this till 5 o'clock. All of our scouts will go out in the morning. If he's in this area somewhere here, we'll spot him. Let's make sure that we get that cap up over the convoy, just in case. We're going to be spreading our air group out over multiple tasks here. That's okay. That's what they're there for. That's why we have so many of these guys. Meanwhile, this convoy's still coming down. Let's see what we got. Lex is ready to launch. Got everybody radiating out except for maybe someone not going up this way. Let's do one more. That's possibly exactly where they are. So, here we go. None done. Course. Bam, bam, bam. Just cover that gap. Rinse and repeat. Off we go. So that's famous Tone Scout. Last to launch. Probably the one that's going to catch the carriers, though. P-40 Warhawks. These guys up here don't care. Begin. Start. Cheese it. Off we go. So, see, this is the thing that I'm curious about here. We want to stick real close to this guy, though. Because they will come to us. There's a carrier up in here. Oh, yummy, yummy. One CV, one CVL. Knew it. Really? One heavy carrier and one... Oh, no, that's light cruiser. My bad. Let's go check this out. I bet you it's a heavy carrier. Famous last words. For you. Where are you guys? Oh, there they are. Dead ahead. What do we got? Okay, so we got Ruiho. This is classified as a heavy carrier, but she's got a much smaller flight group. If I recall, she's still got a dangerous flight group because it's got God dang, what am I doing here? Man. My brain just melted. Those guys are coming right for us, so let's go ahead and pause this. So we're gonna totally chase it. So once I actually ID you here, you are Ruiho. I know you. We fought before. We've met before. 8,000 tons? But see, here's the thing. With her flight group, she's got a lot of zeros on her. Most of the other ones, I don't think they have that many zeros. Call me a liar. So let's go take a look. CVL. So, they got 15, so on some of those, but this guy's got a full additional 6 on here. So, CV, which is Ruiho, got full 21, and Kate's. So, no vowels, which are much, much more dangerous, at least in my opinion. And so, look at this, we get ourselves a little target. just in time for the next video, man. We're right at an hour. And so we'll go ahead and we'll pull the pin on this one. And I'll see you guys back here this weekend. And so we got something to look forward to right at the beginning of the next one. So anyway, questions, comments, concerns. In the meantime, you know where to drop those. If you want to keep up the series, you know what you need to do. Sorry I had a little bit more of a chill episode, but we definitely did a lot of strategic stuff in terms of setting up off we go. So they would totally murder that guy. So, but in terms of setting up our supply chain here, and so if we can beat back Ruiho on this one, which we way outgun her, it's entirely possible that there's another carrier. I mean, we know Shokaku's around here somewhere, so we got to stay frosty. But if we can knock out another one here in March of 1942, we're going to be doing pretty well. So, and so far so good with Task Force 1. So far so good with Task Force 22 and 23. But more action, and hopefully early action, in the very next video. So, see you there. Take care now. Bye.